This is a box. Now let's ask, how can we move this box? Well, we can push it with our hands. Okay? Any other ideas? There is another way to move it. You can move it with a method that works on this box and on every box and every other object, no matter how heavy it is or how far away it is. It works equally as well. Ready? We just move ourselves. If we move, we can pretend that we are standing still and the box is moving in the other direction. And no, that's not cheating. That's exactly how the concept of motion works. Check out these two astronauts, who just happen to wander around in a super void in space, far away from any galaxies and everything, completely alone. From the blue astronaut window, he sees the red spaceship move from left to right. But the red astronaut sees the blue move from right to left. So, in reality, who is the one moving and who is the one who is standing still? The answer is, it depends. From the red's frame of reference, it's the blue who is moving and the red who is standing still. And from the blue's frame of reference, the red is moving and the blue is standing still. Both of these answers are correct. It's not that there is one absolute right answer, that because of the circumstances we cannot figure it out. There is no one right answer. If there was a green spaceship nearby, he could assume that he is standing still and the red is moving in one direction and the blue in the other. And that would be correct too. In fact, in the absence of two or more observers in the universe, there is no such thing as position or velocity. An astronaut alone in an empty universe doesn't need to know where he is or how fast he is going, since there's nothing to compare it to. Physical quantities that depend on the frame of reference we choose to use as a reference point are called relative. While displacement is relative, and while velocity is also relative, the next physical quantity is not relative. It's absolute. That's the rate of change of velocity, also known as acceleration. Let's take a look at these spaceships again from the red's frame of reference. The red sees the blue move in this direction, fire its rockets, stop, and return. But from the blue's frame of reference, it's the red who moved, stopped, and returned. But in this case, there is one absolute right answer. Red, blue, and everybody else know who is the one who fired its rockets. It's blue. Blue even feels the acceleration on his body. So the answer to the question, who changed their velocity or who accelerated, is the same in every frame of reference. And that's why acceleration is not relative. It's absolute. So really, there is no difference between moving and not moving. It all depends on the frame of reference you choose to use. Does this mean, though, that it's equally right to say that the Earth is moving in a circular orbit around the Sun and that the Sun is moving in the circular orbit around the Earth? In a circular motion, the value of the velocity is the same at every point. So does this mean that there is not change in velocity or acceleration? Well, excluding the fact that the Earth's orbit around the Sun isn't exactly circular. No, it's not the same. Why? Because when we say that the rate of change of velocity, also known as acceleration, is absolute, we don't mean change in just the value of the velocity, but a change in the direction of the velocity also counts. Since that's the case, all observers know that the Earth is in a circular orbit around the Sun, not the other way around. So, in conclusion, displacement of an object is relative. The answer depends on the chosen frame of reference. Change in displacement over time is velocity, which is also relative. You calculate the velocity of an object by dividing the distance of the displacement with the time it took for that displacement to happen. For example, a car traveled 1500 meters in 50 seconds. Its velocity is 1500 divided by 50, or 30 meters per second. Rate of change of velocity is acceleration. To calculate the acceleration, you just subtract the final velocity with the initial velocity and divide with the time taken. In the case of the blue spaceship, the final velocity is 10 meters per second in the negative direction, and the initial velocity was 10 meters per second in the positive direction, in a time interval of 5 seconds. So, minus 10 minus plus 10 divided by 5 is minus 4 meters per second squared. The minus sign means that the acceleration is in the negative direction. Now, if you understood all of that, you should be able to solve this. A BMW and a Tesla are on the highway. The BMW in the right lane goes with a velocity of 100 km per hour. The Tesla in the left lane is going with 130 km per hour. The distance between the BMW and the Tesla is 7 km. How long will it take for the Tesla to catch up? What distance will both cars have traveled by that time? The answers to these questions are in the description below. In the next episode, First Law of Motion.